This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. Now that we've seen how easy it is to print out in the terminal any SQL statements that have been generated by the Django ORM whenever we run a query, in this tutorial, we learn how to format the default output. Formatting the SQL statement output to make it much easier to read. Now, although here it isn't necessarily difficult to read this SQL statement, once you have multiple statements being fired off, this is all going to be presented back in a big block. So it will become very difficult to actually read the output. So we're going to learn how to format this output into a much readable manner. So we have two approaches here. The first one is to reinvent the wheel and actually create our own code, which will format this SQL statement. I suppose in some way that is the fun way, but the second approach is just to use the many tools that are available which will perform this operation. So the first tool that we're going to install and use is SQL Parse, a great tool, been around for a long time. You can see it's the latest version was released in September as of last year, as of recording this tutorial, so it is up to date. So let's go ahead and install this. So pip install SQL Parse. If you wanted to take a quick read, you can see that from this initial introduction, this tool is used for parsing, splitting, and formatting SQL statements. So let's get back into the terminal, Control C, clear that. Let's go ahead and just pip install SQL Parse. So the second tool that we're going to use is Pygements. So let's take a look. Looks like we have it here. It's been updated quite recently. Not provide a description. Okay, so let's go ahead and install this. It can always be a little bit off-putting when there isn't any project descriptions here, but if you go to the homepage, everything is nicely documented here in the documentation. As it suggests, this is a Python syntax highlighter. So the first tool is going to allow us to format and present the SQL code, and then we want to then highlight that code to make it easier to read. So this is where the syntax highlighter comes into play. Okay, so let's go ahead and install this. So pip install Pygements. Back in our terminal, just going to paste that in. And then once that's done, let's just make sure that we have updated our pip freeze, updated our requirements. There we go. Okay, so there's a lot to this in terms of the different features and options that are available. And I don't intend to go into any detail in this course, but do check out the documentation, which will definitely be useful if you wanted to make some different customizations. So I'm going to bring in some of the tools now that we're going to need. So from Pygements, we're going to need to import highlight. We're going to be highlighting. This is what this tool is going to provide. Going to provide highlighting, code highlighting. Going to allow us to make our code, our SQL statement, more readable. Now, where are we doing this? Well, we're doing this in the terminal. So from Pygements, we are going to need to bring in the tools that allow us to work within the formatter. Use the tools that allow us to work within the terminal. So let's bring that in, the terminal formatter. And then we just need to determine what type of code we're working with. Well, it's going to be SQL code. There are a few different options here. But we're just going to go for the generic SQL Lexa. So that's going to then hook us up to the Lexa, which I'm going to describe as the way in which the Pygements understands the code and is then able to actually determine how to highlight the code. Because we're telling it, okay, we're using SQL here. So it now knows how to highlight that code or that type of code. Right, so we are going to be formatting. Remember, that's kind of the first stage. We format the SQL first and then we highlight it. So we're going to need SQL parse SQL parse. We're going to need to bring in the format tool, so format. So now we just need to put this all together. So we know how to access the actual query through connection.query. So that's set in place. But I think eventually you're going to have multiple queries outputted. So we're going to put this in a list. So we're going to list this out, connection.query. So we place all the queries in a list. And then what we can do is we can then iterate through that list, each of those queries that may have been generated, and then individually format them. So let's first of all just test to make sure that is working. So we'll just print out maybe the length of Q. Let's print that out first. So what we've got here. So let's go back into the browser. Let's just navigate back to the web page. The server's not turned on. Make sure you turn the server on. So manage.py run server. Let's go back into that browser. Try that again. So back to the home page. Remember the port 8000. Well, that isn't working, is it? They don't need www. Still cannot find it. Okay. Playing up. Okay. Still cannot find it. Okay. So we've got a problem. So cannot import SQL Lexa. Have I done something wrong? Okay, so we need an S here. Lexa, it's not Lexa. I think that's it. Yep, that's the issue. So now we should be able to run our page there. Okay, so now if we drop that back down, you can see that we are running one query. Okay, so that's working okay. Let's go ahead now and we're going to loop through each of the queries that have been captured. We're going to format and output them to the terminal. In actual fact, let me just roll back a second. Let's actually see what is outputted. So I'm going to print this list here. Am I going to do it? No, I'm not. Okay, actually, no, let's run our for loop. So for query set in queue. So for each of the queries that are found, let's now print off query set. So that should say QS. Okay, so what's going to happen now is that we're going to grab our list. We're going to grab the first item in our list and then print it out. That's the task there. Remember the server's turned on. I'm just going to make a refresh so I can capture that, take a look. And you can see here that this is referenced, how this is referenced through SQL. So in order for us to actually grab this or reference the SQL code, we're going to need to do that through SQL here. So SQL is the key. And then the colon, and then we have the value, which is essentially the actual SQL code. So in order for us to actually select the SQL code, we're going to need to know the key, and that is SQL. So now we can go ahead and finish off our loop. So SQL SQL formatted, say. So a new variable. So we're going to need to format. So we bring in the format tool. And then this is where the manual comes into play. But what we're going to do here is just convert our query set into a string. So query set, what do we want to grab from the query set? Remember that was the key. We're going to reference the key that we saw earlier, SQL. That's going to allow us to grab the SQL code. And then we want to specify that we want to re-indent it. So just after the second here, we'll add a comma. Specify re-indent equals true. So then that just specifies the fact we want to re-indent this code. That's the code we want to re-indent to kind of format the code. So that's now formatted. So we can probably print that out now. Give that a go. See what that looks like. Now remember the server is turned on. So back into our browser, I'm just going to do another refresh. That's going to generate a new query. And you can now see that the SQL code is nicely formatted. So now we can go ahead and highlight this. So we use the print for this because we're going to print this out. So we're going to use the highlight tool. Highlight what we're going to highlight, what SQL, the actual SQL that we've just generated, which is stored in SQL formatted variable. And then we are going to need to specify, I'm just trying to remember, we need to specify the SQLexer. We're going to just specify what type of code that's being formatted, if you like. And then we need to also then specify the fact this is going to be presented in the terminal, so the terminal formatter. This is why we brought all the tools in earlier. Okay, let's zoom out a little bit there. There we go. So you can see the whole code. So now when we run again, remember the Django server is still on. Let's just quickly refresh. It's back onto our web page. Let's refresh again. Now this time we've got a problem. Format argument must be formatter instance, not a class. Apologies. Just the way that we're actually calling the terminal formatter. We need the parentheses there. Okay, so let's give that a go again. So do a refresh. Looks like it's okay this time. And you can now see it's highlighted. So that definitely looks much better than it did. Now, again, once we've got multiple queries, that's going to make much more sense. It's going to be a lot easier for you to view all of the queries that is outputted.